Curse the Sun. I'm starting a new weekly series of 3 battle videos. The first battle is in the battle tree. Of course, Gladion themes in all of these, because we all know that is the best theme. And I will be doing commentary throughout these. Did a decent chunk, and actually this is a wild shiny Yan Mega, non-breeded, so it really was surprising about the stats on this. I'm gonna go into my Sigalith here. Of course he's going to predict it, go back to Clink Clang. Now Psychic did a decent amount as well. This is a more specially defensive and defensive set. That was probably an 8 turn kill? 10 turn? Well, Altaria here did quite a lot for being super effective and the defense, special defense on this. Flank going for the flamethrower. It was going to use Screech twice, and they both miss, which is really lucky. Of course, they're going to switch, Volt Switch. I go for Flamethrower. Not predicting, unfortunately. And this one took out my Altaria. It was really strong. Of course, my whole team had nothing to do good against fairies. No steel or poison types. But I don't know why he went Endure, even though I went Moonblast, which non-being stabbed did quite a lot more than what should have done compared to Flamethrower. And Mega Altarias will stab Moonblast. Now this is going to do quite a lot, Comfy, lowering it down to where Yan Mega can take it. Of course, this almost killed. I got lucky. Non-crit. And I get the special attack drop, which has a berry, which really annoyed me. But it outspeed me. I believe it was a solid berry. But of course, you can see it in the video. Bringing back Yan Mega here. I don't think Sigalith returned in this game, the battle. But Air Slash gonna get the kill, and he's gonna bring back in his, I believe, Clink Clink? Yeah. I'm going to go Blaziken, actually. And Yan Mega, you do not want to underestimate Yan Mega. One Air Slash completely demolished this. Of course, this was holding a Sky Plate, but do not underestimate Yan Mega. It can be a sweeper. Also going for the Stab Air Blast. And with Air Slash with a... We got Thunder Wave off, which really didn't do anything. It did paralyze me this turn. But of course that did absolutely nothing. It's going to Volt Switch. It's going to leave me just a little bit of health. But this Air Slash decided it. Just killed it. Next battle was another battle tree video. This one was actually quite long due to Copper Grigas. Leading off with Sharpedo was not the best of starts, since Yan Mega is going to just U-turn demolish this thing, if I remember right. Ice Fang. That sped me there and did almost kill. Of course, I just go for the Bug Buzz, which kills it. The Bug Buzz insta-kill. No, this is not a Pokemon. This is a Pokemon you do not want to mess with. Yan Mega just kind of sweeps here. Of course, go for another. This one goes for Night Slash. I die, of course, but I'm going to go for Moonblast, Altaria. I believe I Mega it first turn. Zoroark is annoying. Yeah, Mega, Moonblast, Stab, multiplied by Super Effective is going to do quite a lot. Yeah, it taunted me, which actually did nothing since I do have Roost on this, but there was no point. It was just Moonblast. But yeah, it was Focus Sash. And I got a special attack drop, like that mattered. Of course, it's going to go for Shadow Claw. Which does... Eh. Shadow Claw is... This thing is especially offensive and just tanks everything. Mind you, these are all wild caught. Yeah, Mega be the hardest to find. And Tickleif was my first. The hardest to catch was Altaria since the Parasol. Moonblast, it does decent amounts, but it's going to Nightshade me. Which, no, Dark Pulse. It Dark Pulse. No, that was Nightshade. It really did a lot. Of course, I get the special attack drop, and it's going to leave another Nightshade kill. Yeah, this is going to be a kill. No, I lived on a certain amount of health, yeah. Yeah, here's where I roost, because Nightshade's only doing such a certain amount. This is the reason it took so long. I'm just roosting every turn since the taunt wore off. And this is where it mattered. I can win this one. I knew I could take another, I believe, yeah, so I went for Moonblast because based on the amount of damage he was doing, I knew I could live. And this is where this used Rest. It really, really, really broke things. Like, this thing just healed. Yeah, it was a Chesto Resto, which was really, really bad for me. Yeah, I went for a Roost because I knew I wouldn't live another attack. It was Nightshade. Of course, I got basically all my health back. And this is where I Moonblast. So I've been alternating Roosts and Moonblast. And this thing's special attack was just dropping, like, all out. I knew I wouldn't live another here, so I just roosted. I kept roosting. Like, legit, I knew that it was going to be super effective against my Sigilyph, and I could not take that risk. Yeah, I went for Moonblast because I knew I would guaranteed to live with this next hit. Nightshade does... Oh, he goes Rest again, that's why. So I got lucky. Of course, it was still asleep with... being idiotic. Okay, leading off with the Top Coco lead. Top Coco is gonna get out of its ability. We're gonna have the pressure from Giratina. We're gonna have the drought, well, extreme drought from Primal Groudon. Airlock from Rayquaza, which is not going to do anything since Primal's overticked in normal, I believe. Groudon's Desolate Land's gonna activate. Now, Top Coco came clutch in this. Dazzling Gleam first turn. I ran Mirror Move, which is not normal on Top Coco sets. Top Coco ran Discharge, Dazzling Gleam, Mirror Move, and Roost. Now, I had Dragon Tail, Fire Punch, a Brick Break, and Precipice Blades on my Groudon. Tapu Koko had a, I believe, Zap. No, it didn't have. Yeah, it had a Zap Plate. But yeah, if I remember right, it had a Zap Plate. Of course, I kill. Okay. That's Dragon Tail. Dazzling Gleam on Tapu Koko is just going to deal a crap amount of damage. Bringing it down enough to make it a Dragon Tail kill on Groudon. Dragon Ascent is going to outspeed and do a decent amount. And I got lucky since this thing has its defense, special defense lowered. I got the kill on this. Shadow Fortune Giratina. That's going to be annoying throughout this game. Okay. We're going to get a Palkia, which stupidly used a water move. Dazzling Gleam is going to be super effective. This whole team was essentially weak to ice, which was really bad for them. Tapu Koko took a great chunk. I could have roosted here, but I just, after using Dragon Tail to feint that, I'm going to go for Mirror Move. And I did not understand Mirror Move in this sense, so instead of going on the Lugia, which would have been super effective, I put it on top of the Giratina, which it also used it. Which kind of killed everything. Aeroblast is going to do a decent amount. Groudon's going to live this, and it's going to drag... No, I used Fire Punch for the stab bonus. Of course, this is going to take it out with Hurricane. And Tapu Koko dies this turn. So I had two Shinies on the team. Now I'm going to bring out Rayquaza, which is Shiny, and Mega. And then Necrozma, which is Steel. Not Steel, it's non-Shiny, which is the Solgaleo. It's running some absurd moves. Sunsteel Strike, I think it was, and Earthquake, Rock Slide, and I remember right. Well, I forgot the last move, but Rayquaza is going to have Dragon Pulse, no Dragon Pulse, Dragon Ascent, Ice Beam, Toxic, and I believe the last one was, I forgot the last one on the last two of these. This was holding a leftover, so we're having an Aeroblast, which is going to do quite a lot. Of course, I'm going to get the Ice Beam outspeed on the Giratina, which is going to be weakened. But Rock Slide, and this is going to be weakened. But it's going to do just enough for next turn. It's going to get that Shadow Force out. Of course, I go for the kill on Lugia this turn. Lugia. And so the field finally leaves out. Okay, it's gonna Aeroblast again. It's going to do a decent amount. I got clutch on this last turn, and they both live. So I'm gonna get Sunsteel Strike out. It's going to bring it down to basically no health whatsoever. This thing just lives on red. So I got lucky there. Amulet Coin, unfortunately, means I could not go Ultra Necrozma. And that does a little bit, I believe, over half? Yeah, it did over half. And it just, it came clutch. I came clutch. It's going to Aeroblast me. This lives, which is absurd. I'm going to go Ice. No, I'm going to use Dragon Ascent to ensure my kill. Because I couldn't risk it. And there we go. And actually, the Ice Beam last time did not weaken due to the winds. It protects only flying types. It does not reduce the move. And Sun Steel Strike is going to take it out for the most amazing win on an amulet coin. Sun Steel Strike. I definitely swapped the items after this, but... Oh yeah, I think I remember what the last... Yeah, I had a Reznor Savali for that. Toxic Reznor, and no... Yeah, no. Well, anyway, Savali's gonna be in the next one. And that is all for this week's Battle Trio. See you next time.